Yuzu is the amazing Nintendo Switch emulator, and in this guide, I'm going to show you how to set it up and get all games working on your computer. So first, before the video starts, I do want to say just a small portion of you are actually subscribed, less than 1% of my views. So if this video was useful, please subscribe down below and also ring the little bell icon so you'll be notified for each new guide. So without any further ado, let's get right into the video. Alright, so for the first thing you gotta do is go to yuzuemu.org, and right here the first thing we are going to look at is the quick start guide. Right here are all the quick start stuff you need to know, but most importantly are the hardware requirements. You do need a pretty powerful system for this, so the minimum is right here, and it's already a pretty modern computer. For the GPU it isn't that intensive, and for the RAM, they really recommend as a minimum is 8 GB or more. You can set a page file and this can increase stability, but I just recommend to have a pretty powerful system to run this emulator. So now you have looked at this and your system is actually working, you can go ahead and go to download right here. Right here you can click download for Windows x64 and it will download the setup. So save it, and you can save this pretty much anywhere in a folder or on your desktop, it is totally fine. Open it up and it will install. So right here you can install what version you want, so of course Yuzu, this is a free version, and if you are a patron you can get the Yuzu early access. I'm going to show both for the setup, so just stick to the one you can use. The early access does have some new features and it might be better for performance or stability or quality in general. So select it, and right here you can select your key. You can copy this, and once it's copied I'm going to close it so I can blur it out. Paste it right here, click verify token. Once this is done, you will see it is checked and I want both, so let's select install Yuzu and click install to get it installed. So while this is installing, I do want to show some stuff for the frequently asked questions. The most common one is a VC runtime error. If this is the case, get the download from right here and download the latest version to fix this issue. And also here, all these errors I'm going to explain, but if you get an error and I don't explain it in this video, there's a big chance it is actually linked in the frequently asked questions. So right now, let's get back, and it says thank you for installing Yuzu. You can find the application list in your start menu. So that's great, click exit and then go into your start menu and click Yuzu. And it actually started up already, so that's also totally fine. Starts up, click OK. And right here it asks if it can share some data to improve Yuzu. I want to make it better, so I'm just going to click yes. Now we do want to actually get the keys, so we got an error previously that there are some components missing. And this is because you need the product keys. So right here I got the product keys and these are dumped for my Switch. And you need to copy these, so Ctrl C. Then in Yuzu, click File, open Yuzu folder, and right here you need a folder called Keys, and if this is not there already, just right click it, click New and make the folder. So that's Keys, all a lower capital, and here paste the file we just got. So product keys in here, and now we are good to go to add our games. So double click it right here, and here select the folder where all your games are. So for me, I got a folder with a few games in it. Double click it and select the folder. And because we didn't restart Yuzu, you need to restart it now. So close it, go back to start and launch Yuzu Early Access. And because the keys are in the correct folder, the games will load up now. As you can see, all the games are loaded right here. And now I'm going to open up Yuzu simultaneously to show the setup for both applications. So on the left we will have Yuzu and on the right we will have Yuzu Early Access. And to actually configure these settings you need to click Emulation and here click Configure. So again, I will do this for both. And we are already starting off with a really important setting. This is the limit speed percent. I really, really recommend to leave this at 100%, so enable this. And if you want to speed up your game, so for example 2x speed would be 200%. And if your PC can handle this, it will run the game at twice the speed. The next thing is a multi-core CPU emulation. Pretty much always keep this enabled unless it is stated else, because this will increase the performance a load. So the other settings are optional, you can check them and see what you want. Next, go to web, this isn't that important. And if you got an account on the user side, you can just select the token right here. This is totally optional. Debug, don't touch any of this. For the UI, you can change this if you want. Doesn't really matter, so do whatever you like. Next is system. And these are all the same, by the way. Again, most of this is the same. Just leave it at the default if you want another region. So for example, Japan, you can select it right here. You can select another system language. The time zone can be selected. And one really interesting thing is the RTC. This is the time. If you enable this, you can here select a custom time. So for example, I don't want it to be 9 p.m. I want it to be 3 p.m. or 5 p.m. or whatever. This can be done here and works totally fine. I don't need it, so I'm going to disable this for now. For the profiles, again, same for user and early access. You can here add new users, so you can have multiple save files for the same game. So if you've got multiple people playing, for example, Fire Emblem, you can right here get multiple accounts for this. You can also click it and here set an image or rename, so you can rename to TechDunk, for example. And right now it is renamed, so that's fine. For services, you can select BCAT right here. And this is actually a service, so you can get some downloadable content. So in Mario Odyssey, Splatoon, and Breath of the Wild, there are a few things you can collect on a specific version. And these will be given via BoxCat. For the file system, don't really mess with this. It doesn't really matter that much. Unless you want to import the same saves from your Switch to Yuzu, this can be very useful. If you don't want this, just keep this at the default. So next is graphics, and here is actually a pretty interesting feature, the API. OpenGL runs pretty great on NVIDIA GPUs, especially with a setting which I'm going to cover in just a second. But for AMD, Vulkan should perform a lot better. Again, this depends on the game, but most of the time Vulkan is better for AMD. I got an NVIDIA GPU, so I got it on OpenGL, but you might want to use Vulkan for your games. So right here, I always recommend to keep this enabled, use disk shader cache. This will compile the shaders to your disk, and this way you can share them across multiple computers. So that's really great. Also, if you use multicore, make sure asynchronous GPU emulation is enabled. This is a great setting which will also increase performance, and if you use multicore, you must enable this also. So again, enable this unless it is stated elsewhere. So next, in the advanced step, there are again some great settings. First is the accuracy level. For some games, like Super Mario Odyssey, the high accuracy level will render some stuff better. So some particles, smoke, will not be rendered on normal, but normal does perform better. So if you want the best visual quality in, for example, Super Mario Odyssey, use high. And if you don't care and just want the best performance, keep this on normal. You can also use VSync. This isn't that important. I'm going to disable this for now. And here's a pretty great setting, the Use Assembly Shader. This is for NVIDIA and OpenGL only. But if you got an NVIDIA card and use OpenGL, this is absolutely awesome because the shaders will compile so much faster. Previously, Vulkan was the fastest, but with an NVIDIA GPU, OpenGL will compile the shaders even faster than Vulkan. So that's insane. The forced 30fps mode shouldn't really be used. User does this automatic now, so just keep this at the default, unless again, it is stated somewhere else. And use fast GPU times is enabled by default, again, keep this like it is. The last one is the filtering. If you put this at 16x, some quality in games like, for example, Pokemon Sword or Fire Emblem will be better. So you can put it at 16x and it should be fine. Some games do have issues with it, so if you got graphical issues and you got it on 16x, put it back to the default. For now, I'm going to stick to the default because I have no clue how it works with What the Golf. So next up are the audio settings. Right here, not much should be changed. You can keep this at auto. You can here enable or disable audio stretching. This can increase the audio quality a bit and prevent stutter, but this does increase latency and sometimes some other issues. So this depends on the game. Most of the time, just leave it enabled. You can here have the output device, again, selected at auto, doesn't really matter. And the volume, I just keep it at 100%. Next up are the controls. Right here there are three things. These two are presets, these are pretty broken, so don't use them. Use custom, click configure. And here I recommend a pro controller unless the game requires something else. Here click configure and configure all the buttons. So click a button and click the key on your keyboard or your controller. Once this is done, click OK. And for the best quality, you can enable docked mode. And if you want better performance, you can disable this. But for resolution mods, most games do require docked mode to be enabled. So I'm going to just enable this right here. There's one exception. This is Pokemon Let's Go Eevee and Let's Go Pikachu. Right here, you need to disable docked mode and enable Joy-Cons docked and click the configure right here. For almost all other games, I really recommend to enable docked mode. Right here, you can enable mouse, keyboard, and D-pad controller. Don't touch this. This won't magically make your keyboard a gamepad. It will just emulate the keyboard if the game supports it. Keep this at the default. You can also enable touchscreen, so if you click on screen, it will register as a touch. Really nice feature, just keep it enabled. Now click OK, and you are pretty much good to go. So click OK right here to save it, and I'm not going to save this one. And there are just a few things I do want to cover right now. First, if you right-click the game, you can here open the save data location, the mod data location, and the shader cache. Of course, in save data, if you've played a bit, there will be the save data. In mod data, you can put mod files, and these can be anything from enhanced resolutions to just a game mod where Mario's stash is removed or something. Right here are the shader caches saved, and if you got one from another computer, you can put those right here. You can here dump some stuff and navigate to the library, doesn't really matter that much. And in properties, there is something really interesting. First of all, there is some information here, that's pretty handy. If you got any mods, updates, or DLC, they will be right here and you can enable and disable them whenever you want. So that's again, is a great feature. And right now there are a few tabs here, and these are pretty handy. So if a game, for example, doesn't work on multicore, you can disable this for just this game. So that's again, pretty great. So for example, Animal Crossing, it works with multicore, so you will to disable this. You can do so for just this game and the other games will have it enabled. The black box means it is the default, so for right now, I'm just going to keep it at the default and it's just fine. So again, click OK if you have changed anything or just cancel it. And to show it actually works, I'm going to launch a game. I don't know if this game works, but we will find out soon enough. So you can see this game works actually pretty good and it is playable. So you can see this emulator does actually work and that's pretty insane. Many games do work great, so just look for gameplay on YouTube if you want to know if a game works and you will probably find out. So if you enjoyed this video, as I said before, please leave a like and subscribe for more content and more guides. I really appreciate each one of you liking, subscribing or even commenting. If you got any issues, comment on my videos or simply ask on social media. For example, Discord is a great place to get support for me or the Yuzu team itself on their own Discord. So I hope you enjoyed it and I'll see you in the next video. I'm out.